Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to another awesome tutorial in the extensions series. Now, today we are going to tackle time interval. In the previous one, we have talked about strings, so go ahead and take a look at the previous video to understand how the starter project works. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, let me just show you what we are going to build out today. I am just going to copy time interval from here and go put it in there and build and run the test project. So let's see what we are going to build out today with the help of an awesome extension. So it says time in your time interval. Okay, let's say, and of course this is in seconds, let's say 100. And as you can see, it typed out as a string, 1 minute and 40 seconds. And of course that is indeed 100 seconds. Let's take a look at some random number here and so on. Maybe not that much, 10 hours, 40 9 minutes and 5 seconds. So that is what we are going to build out today. So let's get started. Okay, let's stop this test project and dive deep into the starter project. Again, go ahead and take a look at the first video in this tutorial series. Now, let me just go ahead and again choose time interval for the example type. And let's take a look at the extensions again. As you can see here, we have already set up as time string function, and currently it returns an empty string. But before we dive deeper into creating this extension, let me just show you what the view controller looks like. So there we are, just find the time interval view controller. So here we have a text field and a label that will output the string that we have created from our time interval, and we are setting it on the view, and that is basically it. We have a handle text change. What we are going to use later on, handles the text change in our text view, our text field, sorry. So, let's go into the extensions and create our time interval string. So what we want to achieve here is add hours, minutes and seconds. So let's add in here let hours equals, let's say, 0 for now. So we get an int, and then let minutes, and that is 0 again, and let seconds is 0 again. So what we want to return here is a string with a format, go ahead and choose this one, and the format will be like follows. So $0 to i, and we have this one, and we just simply copy and paste that one 2 more times and delete. There we go. And the arguments will be hours, minutes, and seconds. Okay, now, this is going to work now, but for now we are going to export all of these zeros like into strings. So let me just go back to our time interval view controller and just simply go ahead and have our labels text to be, let's say, I'm just going to add in here an arbitrary text, or maybe let's just select the text fields text, but for that we need to unwrap it, so let's go ahead and do that now. So guard let text field, rather yet text equals text field dot text, and as you can see this is an optional, so we need it to unwrap this. So So if that doesn't exist, we return. So now this text needs to be converted into a time interval. So let's do that like so. Time interval. We add in here a text and a dot as time string. Now this is again a time an optional. So let's guard let unwrap that. And I will type in here duration or something like that equals time interval text. Else we returned. Okay, and now I can just simply grab this duration and set it in here. And that is all we need to do in the handle text change. Okay, now for now, we are going to have all the time zeros. So let's build and run and see how this works out. So let's just type in here some values. And as you can see, the values here don't match. Let me just double check all of the formatting in the tutorial on my test. And I will just simply copy and paste this here. So don't peek. I will just add it in here. There we go. Yes. So what do we need to have here? Well, first of all, there are 3060 seconds in an hour. So what we need to have here is add in here int and of course self, because we are adding in the time interval. And let's divide this by 360. Again, here we go. Int and self, and again here int and self. So how many minutes are there? So we need to divide this by 60 and grab the modulus of that, and the seconds is the modulus of 60, so the remainder of 60 modulus. Okay, and that should work out pretty straightforward. So let's see if this really happens once we build and run. Okay, there we go. Let's type in here 12. And indeed, once we did add the self into the equation, we do get back the correct form. So 12 seconds, let's add here 200. And there we go, 3 minutes and 20 seconds. Now that is it for this tutorial on time interval extension. And we extended the time interval to be represented as a time string. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified of the next video. And in the next episode, we are going to take a look at dates. So we are going to take a look at a date extension. Really interesting stuff. So I will see you in the next one.